In this session, we will go through how to enter a change request into the system. Under Applications, Jobs or Projects, under All, let's go into Change Management, Change Requests. To enter a new change request, you can simply click on the plus button next to the change request name and it'll go right into a fresh change request. Or you can click on the change request name itself and it'll show you all the existing change requests in the system. And you can click Add. So let's click Add, and we have a new change request that came in for the Amazon warehouse San Antonio. They would like to add an additional 12-foot garage door entrance onto the warehouse. So let's assume the change request came in today, and it's still going to be in a pending stage. And as far as a change request, we'll fill out what type of change request it is. In this case, we'll just call it a change order request. And in the description, I would put a general description of this request. And we'll say add additional 12-foot call it bay door. And we'll be using the change request form, the custom form template right here. And we can also code who we're going to send this change request out for approval to. And in this case, we'll send it out to the Amazon customer. And as far as our job contract line source, if this is a change request that is going to be billable out to a project contract, we're going to want to inherit from the project change order the contract line source. If it is an internal change that is not going to be billed out, you would change this status to none. In this scenario, we are going to be billing this out eventually if it gets approved. So we're going to inherit it from the project change order. We don't have the change order set up yet. We're just at the change request stage. If there is any documentation or drawings or email copies that you want to attach, you could actually attach the files to this change request as well. And then in this scenario here, you can fill out any additional information, you know, as far as what you want to track and show on the document. So let's just put the scope in as the description again. We're going to add a 12-foot bay door. And there's going to be a schedule impact of 2 days if we go ahead with this change. As far as the coding in the project, now you may or may not have that done at this time. So what you can do is you can come into here and either save this as a draft or you can post it. So in this scenario, we're going to save it as a post because we want it to be in the system. And we forgot to enter something in the system here. So let's go back to the change order. And in this scenario, I'm going to save it as a draft at this time. So you can see in the system now that you have a pending change order as a draft. And it's good to have that logged in the system because now it's in there and you can report on, you know, change orders or change requests in process. So let's go back into here. We're ready to put our pricing in. We can go back into Edit. And down at the bottom here, we can code what project it's for. So we'll say it's going to be for the Amazon warehouse, San Antonio. What cost code or cost codes that are going to be affected by this change. And I'm going to just put it in structural concrete for now. And this is, we're going to end up subbing this out, so it's all going to be subcontractor cost. So what you can do here is put in your estimated cost in this cost line. So we'll say it's going to cost us an additional $4,500. And you can enter in the price or the quote that we want to give out to the owner for this change, either by manually keying it in. Let's say we're going to charge them $6,000 for this. Or You could list the price the same as the cost and apply a markup percentage on it. Say we want to make 15% on this. So it'll calculate the $675, and you'll notice it up on top that it'll be in the total price is $5175. So let's go ahead and leave that. And then it's going to show you the primary estimated cost budget that's associated with this project. And based on our workflow type, it will update that estimate accordingly. So as of right now, it's not approved. It's in a pending stage. So basically that will not affect the estimated cost at this point. So I will then go ahead and post this in the system under post. And now it's going to be in there as a pending change order request. At that time, I might want to send out or email the document. So I can come over to here and I can hit print email. And you can either print it out or you can actually email the document. It'll retrieve the email from the contact on the customer record who's ever going to be responsible for getting this change request form. So it's going to go to smiley@amazon.com and who it came from. And then I can click OK. In this scenario, I'll just print it to get a preview of the form. And this is what it would print out. And again, this can be modified in part of your deployment. At that point, you have a pending change request in the system, waiting to go through the next step.